I live in this man, a Jehovah's Witness, and a Mormon to a Baptist. All I knew is that I wanted God. In fact, I came this close to becoming a Mormon because they've got great commercials, let's be honest. And I got the book of Mormon and I read it and basically just didn't know any better. But something inside was me going, you know what, there's something else out there. And I actually literally, my sophomore years when I moved down to the Cape Coral from Myers, Southwest Florida, there used to be a hip-hop show on the radio. And I would flip it over and then listen to like James Dobson and Focus on the Family and like the most extreme dynamic you could imagine. But I remember this guy preaching on the radio one time and he basically told me, he said, if you've never given your life to Christ, you can give your life to Christ no matter where you're at. And something about that began to resonate in my mind and I said, all right. And I got down on my knees and fell true. And I asked Christ, that's my life. And I'll never forget, I went to school the next day and things were just different. I didn't want to do what I used to do. I didn't want to say what I used to say. God began to work and work in a very real way. And so right around 15, 16, I actually started going to church for the first time in my life. My mom would actually drop me off and pick me back up. And God began to really work in a very real and tangible way. I got a Bible and I literally had read through it in 6 months. Now it was the King James Version, I didn't quite know what I was reading, but the point was there was something there that began to just really begin to spark something in my life. And the more I got to know God, the more I wanted more and more and more. By my junior year of high school, I knew God was calling me into the ministry. And that's all I wanted to do. And I was so in love with this Jesus who had set me free, who had changed my life. And at home, things were still kind of whatever. But I finally realized that there was power in forgiveness. There was power in learning how to love. There was power in Christ. And then finally, I tried everything this world had offered me and found something real in Christ. And the funny thing was, is that God took away my music because I was so into hip-hop, I had to give it all up. I threw out all my cassettes. Yeah, shout out to cassettes. So,
eight tracks,
not that far back. But basically, God gave it back to me. I began to listen to Christian hip-hop music, not sitting down thinking that I'm going to do this one day. My illustrious career began because I broke my nose pole vaulting my senior year of high school. No, the pole did not go up my nose. Basically what happened was I broke my nose and was stuck at home. And for about 2 weeks, I stuck there. And out of boredom, I wrote this Christian rap, out of sheer boredom. And so basically, I went to this retreat called Chrysalis, and it was a weekend retreat. And at this weekend retreat, God did some major things in my life. It was the first time I ever went for Christ. And I say this with kind of personal, because I had a youth pastor at the church I was at, who was not a hip-hop guy by any means. In fact, probably looked at what I was doing right then was like a complete waste of time. But he never told me that. And he laid disciplines in my life and he loved me. And the first place I really, really rapped was youth group. And he would just, you know, up there like 20 kids and then, you know, doing my little thing. And that's all I really knew because it's all I had. But he loved on me and disciplined, you know, showed me the disciplines I still practice to this day. And so from that point, basically, I moved out when I was 18. And about a couple years later, I wound up working as a youth pastor in the inner city part of Fort Myers. I was an inner city youth pastor. We bussed in all my kids from the housing projects. And that's what I did for about 3 years. That was my full-time ministry. And all the time I was doing music, right towards the end, I just felt like God was calling me into doing the hip-hop full-time. But you don't exactly wake up one day and be like, I'm going to be a rapper tomorrow.